In fact, the T statistic I gave you is the one that we get when we do a hypothesis test for the plane flight distance versus cost that we talked about earlier. When we do linear regression in R, the statistical program that I've briefly mentioned before, this is the output. Usually you'll do software to do any type of hypothesis test, whether it's on a sample mean or two sample means or the correlation coefficient or the slope or whatever. The important thing is that you understand the meaning of the software output. Here you see the t value for the slope is pretty big, 5.77, the same value I gave you earlier. And the p value is pretty small. There are three stars by it, indicating that the p value is small enough to reject the null. Here are the significance codes, which list the alpha levels. We see that three stars means we can reject the null at the significance level of 0.001. Since the slope is significant, we know there's a true relationship between the distance traveled and the cost of the plane ticket. Note that we can also conduct a hypothesis test on the y-intercept, and in this case we see that it's not significant, the p-value is pretty high at 0.2, and there are no stars by it. This means that we're not totally sure that the true intercept is at 161.38775. However, in many cases, the estimate for the intercept is not of interest to researchers. One reason is that this value could have no meaning in real life because x equals 0 may not be realistic. For example, the price of iPods at the year 0 AD. iPods weren't even invented back then.